Nope, same thing. I was expecting that leaving it all night, it's gonna be fixed by its own, but it's waiting for me still. Anyhow, this is yesterday. I was not remember this car. This is with four different tires and still has four different tires. Anyhow, I'll be more happy if I see that the owner changed the tires and repair the engine and other stuff later on. But anyhow, that's me. Now, let's lock it, lock the camshafts, remove the cam adjusters. The bolts here looks like that it's been open and closed more than twice. At least how it looks like. And nobody changed before. Definitely somebody was here before. Camshafts, we're not gonna lock it at 40 degrees. Actually, now it's at 40 degrees. Let me see back the plate, it's okay. Yeah, this one, the exhaust camshaft looks a little bit out. Maybe I'm wrong, but I'm gonna figure it out now with the tools. Anyhow, so we're gonna be at 40 degrees, and when we're gonna remove all the cam adjusters, I'm gonna be able to spin the camshafts without touching a valve on the piston. That's why this is a safety at 40 degrees. You can even rotate 360 the camshaft without touching a valve on the piston. There is no problem with that. But you cannot rotate the crankshaft, only the camshaft. Anyhow, so let's start to see what we have. Didn't fell anything inside, right? No, it didn't. And somebody before used here sealant. You are not apply sealant here, you're just changing the seal. And everybody happy. Yeah. Carefully lifting up the rug. Or you know what? Leave it as this at the end when we're gonna put the cover. There, it's not bothering. I'm not blowing here anything, don't feel anything inside the engine. You're gonna be nice, you're gonna be safe. Or I'm gonna come with a magnet and pick it up. Anyhow, let's start. Yeah, I was right. 40 degrees down, damper pulley. Trying to put the bridge here front and it's not entering full inside. That means I was right, unfortunately. Anyhow, yeah, there's no problem. Even from this side, yeah, it's not coming down. Whoops. Okay. Plan B, getting the 27. This 27 to insert inside, I have sanded a little bit. So you're able to insert it here without any problem and hold it and loose the bolt. In this case, you're not forcing the tools to lock the camshaft. You're holding the camshaft, you're coming with 80 millimeters and you're losing it one at a time. And when it comes the time to put it by again, you're securing it properly without forcing the tools. You don't want to force the tools, because if you start forcing the tools to go inside, there are some wear on the tools and then you're not locking properly. 101 actually. Anyhow, yeah, 18 and start opening. I'm coming here, I'm putting the 27 here, and then this is happening. 1 second, don't fall down and destroy the radiator. We have an intake cam adjuster with failure. It's not locking. Yay. Continue. God damn it, and I don't have. Do I have a cam adjuster now? Who knows? I have to go through more than 20 pieces to see if I have any healthy. Anyhow, proceed. Let's take it inside the engine room, wash it and open it. One, two, three. I have three rings problem. Anyhow, I will get sense all of them. And one bolt is different, and these are the same. And I put a bit of, if I count the length, you're gonna be stretched definitely. The reading plate here has a step. Looks like, anyhow. I have to wash to check first this one, because if this is not sealing, it's losing oil pressure. If the washer of the bolt here, it's not sealing on this surface, it's not the best thing. You're gonna lose an oil pressure. Yep. Anyhow, like I said, inside the engine room, washing it, open it, see what we have. Alright, intake, exhaust, intake, exhaust. This is the intake cam adjuster from the bank one, from the passenger side, the one that was not locking. So, honestly, I haven't seen this kind of wear. It moves so much, I mean, and in, what can I say? Honestly, first time I see such a thing. Compared with the other cam adjuster, let's put side by side. Take a look, what can I say? First time I see that. That means it was making sound for a long time. Let's see also, one second, let's put this back again. No, yes, here, sorry, don't mix it up. Let's see the small pin it has inside. And the small pin doesn't have any wear. It looks like it's not even belong to this cam adjuster, honestly. See how he machine the plate. This, if you want my opinion, this doesn't belong to this plate, that's for sure. This one, for example, this is the exhaust cam adjuster, and you can see that it's been smooth from one side here, and from the other side it looks like brand new. And the exhaust cam adjuster does have a wear, it's fine. This cam adjuster does have a problem at all. It's not final wash, that's why you see like that. It just removed the oil. So this exhaust cam adjuster, by flipping the pin, give a bit tension on the spring and putting it back again together, you're not gonna have any problem, that's for sure. Then, I said this is intake, this is exhaust. Yes, this is exhaust. The other exhaust cam adjuster, again, same thing, there is no problem. It won't have any problem. Once again, flipping the pin, give some tension to the spring, putting the admins that way, here, and everybody happy. This intake cam adjuster, it's on the limit. I have seen worse than this, but this is not the best. And definitely, definitely I'm not gonna close this one. This is, how in hell? Anyhow, let me see now what I have. Let me take out the box and see what cam adjusters I have and what's the condition of the cam adjusters. Good luck. I have also here, I forget to mention something. I saw one friction washer that has here one dent. I have no clue how this happened. Anyhow, these are the rings that was healthy, these are the rings that was broken, the rest are outside. That's a reading plate. If I remember correct, you cannot purchase this separate. If I remember right, you have to purchase the reading plate complete altogether. Anyhow, let me see what I have and what can we do here, and ask also at the office what they want from me to do. Definitely, what can I say for sure is that the two exhaust cam adjusters, I can close it and I can even put it back again. The intake cam adjusters, nope. I mean, no, sorry, this intake. This, you can see from here, this one like this, it's the intake. And this one, it's the exhaust. Just don't mix it up. That means, What does mean that one? I have said that before. You have that here that says that this is ein for intake, aus for exhaust. So you're not mixing it up, this one, because there is a part number and the in ein, and there is also this that's giving where it's locking and how it's rotating. The exhaust retarding, the intake advancing. Anyhow, yeah, what I was saying, let's see what I have.
Here they were, I said that, I think that one has a step here. Just a second. Maybe through the mobile it will get me much more easy. No, it looks okay.
Bolts, definitely we're gonna replace it. The friction washer, definitely we're gonna replace it. The rings, I don't want to trust these rings, honestly. Reading plates, I can wash it, because now it still has a carbon on it, it's not clean. I just pass everything through the petrol to remove the oil and to see what I have in front of me. Yeah, let's see what I have now. Digging, searching, shit, I hate that. Because I don't have a space, I went and I washed the reading plates. Okay, and the exhaust cam adjusters, since there is no problem. The intake cam adjusters, I didn't wash it, I just washed with petrol a little bit. The exhaust I washed it, don't be, I mean, what's the difference? Let us see. This height is now and this height was before. Not a big deal, but it's much better to be like that than to be like this. Anyhow, yeah. Same thing also for the gear bag, it was like this, this is like that now. It looks a little bit better than before. It's not been washed. Yeah, anyhow, so, because I don't have a space, I'm gonna close the exhaust cam adjusters, like I said, standing by this one, standing by the intake cam adjusters. Plus, I think I saw something, not on this plate, 1 second. Yeah, on this plate, there is a heat here. Somebody hit the plate here. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna get one from the intake. I have to go to wash it. Okay, so it won't have any problem. This located here, this located here, there is no problem. It can be in a clean surface, no big deal. But this one has a heat here, and this cam adjuster has a problem here with the plate. Who gives an F about this plate, right? So this will gonna stay here. This I'm going to wash it. Give me a second to go to wash it. Don't be like shit. How nice, I'm getting this plate, I'm going to wash it, and I see a mark here. There is a heat right over here. So, yeah, I washed for no reason. Anyhow, no worries, I'm going to give back to the customer, to the owner, washed. This is the other one that has a mark. So, I took from this exhaust cam adjuster this upper plate, and I exchanged it with the intake from this one, and it was this, actually. That has the heat here, and then I took this plate and I went to wash it, and at least this is looks nice without any mark. Why it's important to don't have any heat on any mark? Because this relying to seal it on this surface here. So it's not the best thing to heat this plate, because there is no O-ring, there is no gasket, there is no nothing. There is a metal with metal contact, has one rate, let us say, of leak, but it's been, how to say that now, they already calculate the amount of leak that we're gonna have from here, for example, from metal to metal contact. That's why it's not been completely sealed. Anyhow, so that's it. Now I can put it together. What's the pin? All right, so flipping the pin upside down. Give some tension on the spring, put some lubricant, closing back together. The bolts already wash it. Not bad, not bad. A little bit oil on the treads, one drop of oil on the treads. I want to see also if there is any mark on the bolts, because this one, this mark, it's near to the bolt. I don't know if somebody hit here the bolt. Anyhow, we're gonna find out that. We're gonna figure it out. I have a bolt, so it's not something crazy. Let's close it to create some space and bring the box with the used cam adjusters. Two exhaust cam adjusters ready. AMG up, part number up, the holes here up, nice and torqued down. These two are ready for installation. I don't have friction washers. Now, I brought the heavy box. Dang it. Wish me luck to find on this mess. I have a rings. Yeah, not bad. Not bad at all. I have to see the surface to see that it's nice and shiny. Okay. Not bad. Have also this. Okay, now, from all this, I have to find the upper cover, two pieces, because this has a heat and the other one has a heat. So I'm gonna make one box and I'm gonna give it back to the customer, this actually. So I need definitely at least one plate. One bottom plate, this is gone. This goes back to the owner. I hope that we can get back, because this box coming heavier and heavier. And the irony, all these cam adjusters are from our engines. There are some engines for Darton sleeves in the United States, and there are some engines in Italy for a Nikasil. Anyhow, I wanna see when they come back, the engines, what I'm gonna install when we are giving the used camshafts. That's a different story. Anyhow, yeah, I don't want to think about it. These are fine, these are okay, this is nothing to do with that. Like I said, I need this. Let's get one by one, open one by one. At least I didn't torque it down, it's loose all the bolts. No, it's not loose all the bolts, some of them they are loose, yeah, obviously. Anyhow, now, rings. I want to show some difference between these rings and the other rings. I want to see also if there is any sharp point, because if there is any sharp point here on the edge of the ring and it bites on the soft aluminum housing, it can destroy the housing and the ring itself. But this most probably is coming from lubrication. This is a lubrication issue. And I saw the color inside of the engine, I saw the color of the gears. There is a burnt oil, that means they didn't change often the engine oil. The same thing happened also in the past, from what I have seen up to now. Anyhow, stop talking, start working to find out, to finish the story. Again, I don't have a friction washers new. I don't have any new bolts. We need to order new bolts and new friction washers. But now they open. They open now. All right. Let's do it. And that's it for the cam adjusters. I found this one and this one. Compare it with the old one. It looks a little bit better. I would say that it's by 80% healthy, this one, and this by 70%. If you compare it with this, it's a little bit better, right? And if you compare it with this, it is better. So that's it. Let's go back to the customer. The rings all back in place. Finish the old one, I have it over there. Then I change also this. Does have a mark. This one or this one. Let's close it. Let's close it. This is the old one. This goes back to the owner. This one, this took place with the bolts, the friction washers, and the rings going back to the customer. All the rest going back to the engine. Then I don't remember the bolts, because I saw one hit on it. No, you know what? When it comes to that, keep it there. Now, gloves, oil. There you are. Let's put it together. And then what? And then friction washers and bolts. So what? Even if I do it. Anyhow, yeah. Let's continue. I have to check also this one, see if there is any extra wear in the housing. Plus, I didn't wash this. I washed only with petrol, so I have to go to wash it. This is clean already. Yeah, nice. So yeah, let me go to wash again all these things, putting it together, and then waiting for the bolts and the washers. Yeah, that's it. Finished with the cam adjusters. All four ready. Reading plates ready. Let's go to see what are we gonna do with the housing, with the solenoid housing that's controlling the variable. Let's bring it inside. Actually, first I'm gonna wash it, then I'm gonna bring it inside to see with what I have to deal with. I brought both inside. One I know that has a big, yeah, this is disaster there. It's definitely gonna use it. Has a big lip. Yep. Forget about this housing. And this housing, it's not the best. And here it's even more. You can see the step there. Oh boy. Yeah, let me see what I have. Leave this there. What I'm gonna use for this, if I have a housing, I think I should have a housing healthy. I'm gonna use only the solenoids, the camshaft position sensor, and I'm gonna swap it to the other one. If I don't have complete, let me see. Alright, I found two, this one and this one. These are the old one, like I said. So this one, it looks nice. I don't feel any step here. Same thing here. I don't see any mark. And the same thing on this. It looks like it's okay. So I need to wash both of them. I have to remove the this one, it's empty. Yeah, I need to go for washing, because it's a little bit disaster. And this one, I need to remove the camshaft position sensor and the solenoid, washing it. Then I'm gonna get the parts from this. I have to clean also the sensors, because it looks a little bit disaster and the solenoid looks nice and clean. Anyhow, yeah, tell me about it. So, some of you, you're gonna say, okay, why you're not getting two used one from a scrap yard? Why? Some of the parts, first of all, if it's closed the engine, they're not gonna open for you an engine to give you the housing. So what does mean that one? You're gonna get the housing, they're gonna be thrown down with other parts, and you're gonna have scratches here, and most probably inside gonna be disaster. Anyhow, I've seen that before. And what's happening here? It's coming the driver, our driver here, all right? He's getting the part from the scrapyard, he's bringing it to me here, I'm taking the part, and I'm saying to him, no, this is okay, let us say, but this is not okay. Give it back and get another one. And then like this we can spend, let us say, 2-3 days going back and forth to find one healthy part. Like this, since I have it here, you're gonna tell me when it comes the time to close an engine, like I can, yeah, I know, but I hope at that time to need more parts and get, let us say, not one piece or two piece, get, let us say, 10 pieces. Out of 10 pieces, if I found 5 healthy, I'll be happy. This, from this point of view, anyhow, and don't keep the car here 4 days looking for a parts. Anyhow, like I said, yeah, going for washing, cleaning, first this, then taking the solenoids and the camshaft position sensors, washing it, and then swap it on this. Continue. Now, after washing it,
one final inspection. I didn't pay attention outside, I pay attention inside, and the oil gallery is there, from where it's passing the oil and where it's bleeding out the oil, this kind of stuff. So, and keep in mind that we are talking about used part, we are not talking about brand new. There is nothing, there is no problem if the owner, he wants to put a new cam adjuster, or if he wants to put a new housing, but this housing looks amazing and does have a single problem, and that's how it looks like outside. That's the other one. This was more dirty, this was almost clean because I washed before and I washed again, so it has a little bit there but doesn't go away, and has a little bit here, but again, you're not gonna feel anything inside. Here I have to blow it again, that's some garbage, no problem. Here inside, all right, okay, nice, not bad. At least we found something like that. Now, getting solenoids and comes up with the sensors, cleaning it, and then swap it on it. So I have reached at this point, I'm start opening the solenoids from the old housing, and I'm opening this solenoid, and the screen that has inside, it flew away. All right. This is where I am up to now. That's the new seal, by the way. Anyhow, yeah. Leave it on the side, I'll continue with that. Okay, that's it. This is the one. Not bad. This is the other one. The plugs, the cables, does have any problem or something. All right, then, like I said earlier, the plates, the cam adjuster plates, the rings, the bolts and the friction washers, these are the two housing, and this is a solenoid. Putting yourself in this nylon bag, back to the owner. I don't want to have it here. Like I said, I don't want to use it anywhere, this one. Who knows, maybe some machine shop that can machine it, let us say, to get 1/10 of a millimeter, then we're gonna be fine. I have no clue, because it has specific clearance, the rings, from the hole here around. I'm not putting it now inside, because there is no oil here, there's no oil here on the housing. I'm gonna put oil only at the end, when I was ready, when I'm gonna be ready to install it. Some oil here inside, and some oil here on the rings, and the rings, one ring, let us say here, one ring at 6 o'clock, one at 12 o'clock, and the other one at 6 o'clock. Most probably, like I said before, they're rotating, definitely. But me, I'm putting it like that. Anyhow, I'm crossing it, let us say, because different, let us say, channel this one, different this one, and this don't escape from. Yeah, that's it. Now, whenever they're gonna bring me the bolts and the friction washers, then I'm gonna install it. Otherwise, we're gonna stay there. Yeah, that's it. Otherwise, we're gonna stay here. Thank you very much. If I receive it today, I'm gonna start taking the camera. Otherwise, tomorrow. I brought the covers inside just to put the new seals. The old seals are here inside with the old parts. So that's the new seals. Okay, I bring it also inside for what? To see, to compare the color, to see if it's too much different, but it's not, it's nice, it's not bad. Because if it is more bright than this, then the eye is gonna see direct the difference, it's gonna be too much, but it's a little bit, it's not so much.
And I brought inside, I want to open also the seals here to flip it, and then I saw also that. I'm gonna change also this to finish the story.
Dang it.
Now it's okay. I flip the seal, what has inside. I change also this one. This is a used one actually. I remove the broken one. Yeah. And like I said earlier, waiting for the bolts and the friction washers. Yeah, this is official the end of this part. I found the friction washers. We also have in stock friction washers, but we are so smart and we don't have bolts for the cam adjuster. How nice. Anyhow, so tomorrow we're gonna have the bolts. That means this is gonna stay here, and that's the end of this part of the video. Yeah, another one day, not day, half day waste for no reason. One car inside of the garage, blocking the space, and me, I have a patch inside of the engine room. Okay, this is the old patch, I can throw it even out. Yeah, you can tell me, come on, you don't have an engine open inside, right? Yeah. Yeah. Never mind. Thank you very much.